Housing outranks groceries, power bills and every other cost of living pressure, according to the latest news poll. For more on this, let's bring in former Labor Senator Graham Richardson. Hi there, Graham. Always good to talk to you. Obviously, housing is a big part of spending, but it is, you know, these problems have complex causes and it's long term. So do you think right now the fact that it's being dumbed down for the upcoming elections is going to lead to, you know, not the best decisions being made?
Well, it seems to me that housing's just not getting the priority from either side that it needs. Obviously, there are a lot of people who are desperate to get a house and can't. And that's just not a good thing in a country like this, which really ought to be able to provide decent housing for people. We're not a huge country in terms of population. You'd think we'd be able to do a lot better than we're doing. So I'd say that both Albo and Dutton have really got to have a look at this. Because it matters to people. You know, you go and talk to families and there's always somebody looking for a house. And, you know, it's very, very difficult to find them.
But do you think of all the proposals on the table, are they all going to be effective? Should we be going for a portfolio? What are the things that would work? For example, the build-to-rent bill didn't get the support recently.
No, look... I think Albo's interested in trying new things and has a crack. Unfortunately, the Liberals are never interested in trying new things and they knock him back. And that means that we don't get to see if there's a better way of doing things. The Conservative people like you to just keep doing the same thing. Problem is, if it's not working, then doing the same thing again and again seems pretty stupid to me. We need to find new ways on housing, and we're not going to do that unless the coalition agrees to at least open its eyes, open its ears, and see if we can come to some arrangement.
What solutions or proposals have you seen that you think are worth a crack?
Well, I think that whatever solution you go for here is about money. You know, houses cost money. A lot of money. Now, we've also got a problem now of a brain drain, if you like, in the sense that we've lost a lot of tradesmen who we really need, and we haven't been getting them in the import quotas at sufficient levels. So we've got a real drag there on any attempt to build housing, a really big drag. If you don't address that, then it doesn't matter what you do in housing, it'll never get fixed.
Sort of related to this issue is the fact that the Greens are threatening to not support the RBA reforms if they don't force it, or if the government doesn't force it to make a rate cut. What do you think?
I think most of the things the Greens do are just monumentally stupid. And this is yet another one. The idea of Adam Bandt second-guessing the Reserve Bank is laughable, risible, stupid. And it just we shouldn't be talking about it. This guy is just, I'm trying to think of a nice word, twit, it'll do. And he just has got no idea, not a remote clue on how to sort out Australia's problems.